Congestive heart failure is a condition that affects nearly 5 million Americans of all ages and is responsible for more hospitalization than all forms of cancer combined. Heart failure is a chronic, progressive condition in which the heart muscle is unable to pump enough blood to meet the body's needs for blood and oxygen. In this video, we will discuss how congestive heart failure develops, the symptoms, causes, risk factors, and consequences associated with it. Heart failure can occur if the heart cannot pump or fill adequately. This tricks the kidneys into retaining fluid and sodium in the body, resulting in fluid accumulation. Symptoms include fatigue, shortness of breath, fluid accumulation, lack of appetite or nausea, malnutrition, and death. About 50% of people who develop CHF die within 5 years of diagnosis. Certain conditions such as narrowed arteries or high blood pressure gradually leave your heart too weak or stiff to fill and pump efficiently. Heart muscle damage can also lead to CHF. It can have many causes, including several diseases, infections, alcohol abuse, and the toxic effect of drugs such as cocaine or some drugs used for chemotherapy. Chronic diseases such as diabetes, HIV, thyroid conditions, or a buildup of iron may also contribute to heart failure. Since high blood pressure and heart disease can cause CHF, the risk factors for those diseases are also risk factors for CHF. Smoking, obesity, excess alcohol consumption, irregular heartbeats, poorly controlled diabetes, and valve-related heart disease are risk factors for congestive heart failure. Fluid accumulation in the abdomen, lungs, and extremities results in weight gain and difficulty breathing. Cardiac cachexia is a wasting syndrome associated with CHF that includes loss of lean tissue, muscle mass, and bone mass. Weight gain to fluid accumulation may mask the bone and muscle loss. Obesity can also disguise these symptoms. Malnutrition has been shown to be predictive of worsened survival and increased length of stay in patients with heart failure. The risk and prevalence of malnutrition in advanced heart failure has been shown to be as high as 90% in some studies. Organ damage can also occur due to reduced blood flow and accumulation of fluid. As you consider the risk factors and complications, you should be thinking forward to identify how nutrition and specific food changes will be used to prevent and treat it. Also consider what symptoms may interfere with eating and how we can improve it.